Welcome, my debaucherous friends, to our first ever cigar review and rating. Today, we're going to be going through the Rocky Patel 60. Now, let me warn you, this is not going to be like any other cigar review you've seen before, because we believe that an average cigar should get an average rating, and an average rating on a scale of 1 through 100 is a 50. That being said, let's get into it. Today, we're going to be reviewing the Rocky Patel 60-60. And the reason it's called the 60-60 is because this is the 6x60 Gordo size in the box pressed form. Let's open this up and see what it's all about. Right. This band is absolutely gorgeous. They put a lot of time and effort into it. And they didn't just put one band on, they put three. One, two, and three. Well, this is a foot, but it's still part of the band. It's beautiful. It's very intricate. The gold foil is absolutely wonderful. I love the royal blue and the red. And then this white piece has a picture on it. I can't tell exactly what it is. It looks like a tobacco leaf. I'm not sure, but the picture doesn't matter because the red, white, and blue and gold theme is absolutely amazing. I really like it. Now, this cigar was made in commemoration of Rocky Patel's 60th birthday, and they really did something special here, as you'll see. All right, well, that foot came off pretty easily, as should be expected when it comes to the foot of a cigar. Or the foot band. These bands, they don't move at all. So we'll see how that equates later when it comes time to taking them off. Will they rip the tobacco or won't they? All right, let's smell this thing and see what it's all about. Wow. That smells like every cigar I've ever smelled in my life. It smells like tobacco that was stored in some kind of cedar container. I don't understand why these other reviewers smell it and what they get out of it, because I've never smelled a difference, not once. Nope, still tobacco. Alrighty. Another thing we're not gonna be doing here is a cold draw. See, I'm not gonna smoke this cold. Because one, that would defy the laws of physics, and two, I'm not smoking it cold, so those aren't the flavors I'm going to be getting. Let's talk about the wrapper for a second. This wrapper is, I would say the dryness is about normal. It's not too oily and shiny. Up towards the top, it's a little bit more oily and shiny, which is good, because that's where your lips are going to be touching it. But the great part about this wrapper is it barely has any veins. It has practically no color defects. I don't see any black spots or gray spots or anything anywhere. This is a gorgeous leaf that they chose to wrap this cigar with. And let's talk about that for a second. This is the San Andreas wrapper from Mexico, and the binder is Nicaraguan as well as the fillers. Let's get into it. Toast the foot a little bit, and the initial impression is pretty good. It's definitely in the medium body-ish range, and it has a lot of flavor. I like it, it's really good. It's in the house of flavors that I enjoy. Now let's talk a little bit about the smoke quality. This cigar The smoke quality is pretty average, if you ask me. It's not, you know, very silky, and it's not too harsh. It's a little bit dry, but, you know, right there in the middle. Personally, I really enjoy the really smooth, silky, pillowy kinds of smoke. I don't know if a lot of smokers enjoy the drier type, but if you do, let me know in the comments below. I'm curious. The draw. This is a larger size, but the draw is exceptional. I've smoked some of the smaller sizes. It's a little bit tight at the beginning, but then it opens up pretty quickly into the cigar. But in this 60 size, it's a pretty good draw. I really enjoy it. I get a lot of volume of smoke. It's very easy. I don't have to pull too hard on it. And I've smoked a lot of these. My team has gone through a bunch of these over the past couple months, and we have noticed that the draw has always been consistent. These are a very well-constructed cigar, and they've obviously put some of their better rollers on this one. Let's talk a little bit about the burn line. This cigar is really well crafted. Out of all the cigars we've smoked over the past couple months, it has consistently had an even burn line, which is very hard to come by. Not a lot of people can pull that off. All right, I'm gonna go away for a second, and I'm gonna come back when we get closer to taking off the first of the two bands and see how that performs. And we're back. I'm really enjoying the cigar. I'm pretty deep into that first third now, and the flavors have been awesome. They're very calm, but they're there. You know, you notice them. They're delicious, not too overpowering. And the body of the cigar, it's not burning my tongue or wrecking my mouth, which I prefer. I know some guys like to numb their tongue, but I really like to taste the flavors as much as possible, and this cigar is allowing me to do that. And let's talk a little bit about this ash. This ash indicates a good construction, but the ash isn't everything. Sometimes you get a flaky ash, and that just indicates some short fillers maybe, or different kinds of minerals in the soil. Also, the color of the ash can indicate that as well. Some guys can tell you exactly what's in the soil of the country that it was grown in, or the region the country was grown in, just by the color of the ash, which is pretty crazy. I'm not on that level, but hopefully one day I will be. Speaking of the ash, let's give it its first little tamp. Oh, and that came off perfectly. So nice and smooth. And now it's time to remove the band, or at least the first one. Let's see how this goes. Oh, seamless. You know, I've had a lot of bands ruin my cigars over the years, and there's nothing that upsets you more, especially with a higher priced cigar like this one. So I really appreciate when the manufacturer or that person at the factory puts that band on perfectly. Good job to you, whoever banded this cigar. And that goes for whoever's been banding all these cigars, because out of all of the Rocky Patel 60s that I've smoked, I've never once had an issue with a band. And since there is a footer and two bands, there's been a lot of opportunities, a lot more than normal, for that band to ruin the cigar. And it's just never happened. Great job, high quality control right there. Now you might notice, I'm not, like most reviewers, talking about all these crazy flavors that you get out of it. I don't taste leathers or earth or peppers or chocolates because I don't have a chef's palate. And I don't think the average smoker does either. I see a lot of people commenting in the forums online saying, I can't taste some of these crazy tastes that other people are tasting. Am I just bad at this? Am I doing it wrong? And in some cases, the answer is yes. Sometimes your cigar is improperly humidified, and other times it is just that you're a normal smoker, like me. I'm a casual smoker, I can't taste those things, but I know what I like, and I like the taste of this cigar, and this cigar tastes like some pretty good tobacco rolled up and packaged for your enjoyment. Honestly, that's a fantastic cigar. They do a really good job. It is definitely paying homage to Rocky Patel and his 60th birthday. Let's talk a little bit about the quality of the smoke. This is smoking pretty cool. And I want to point out, this is the Gordo size, or the 6x60. Rocky Patel calls this one the 60 for obvious reasons. When you smoke a larger ring gauge versus a smaller ring gauge, the flavor and the experience is going to change a lot. So when you see a reviewer reviewing a particular cigar, you have to try that cigar that they're reviewing, because I've smoked this in a Robusto size and I don't enjoy it as much as I do in this 6x60 size. This larger size allows it to smoke cooler, lets you experience a little bit more of the flavor with less strength. And also, when manufacturers make smaller sizes, they sometimes have to take out some of the tobacco leaves that go in there, or else they'll end up rolling it too tight, which means they have to adjust the flavor profile. So even though this is a very consistent flavor across the different sizes, it can easily be manipulated by the size. So keep that in mind when you're watching other reviews. To go a little bit deeper into the consistency, my team has smoked quite a few of these over the last couple months, and we've been smoking it before that too. And this cigar has always been extremely consistent. We've picked it up from a few different local shops as well as ordered some online, and the flavor has been pretty much consistent the whole way. I mean, I haven't noticed any major fluctuations. There's always going to be some fluctuations, but this one is very close to the same with every stick we've smoked. And that is a testament to the kind of quality that Rocky Patel put into this stick. And that's probably why they're charging a little bit more for it. They're obviously using finer tobaccos, but they're putting a lot of effort into making this very high quality across the board. Because when you get it from different shops and you get it from online, each of those cigars has been stored in a different way. Sometimes they're stored in massive humidors, sometimes small humidors. When they travel, they, you know, experience different humidities. And this one doesn't seem to be affected by any of that. I can't say that for every cigar out there. This is a fantastic cigar. I'm really enjoying it. And I think it's going to rate pretty high for our first review. I don't know if you can tell because of the lighting here, but I'm getting a lot more smoke now. I'm about close to the halfway point, and it's just opening up the flavor profile. And let's pair it with a little bit of scotch in the mouth now. I love that. I love that pairings really change your experience. So what happened was, when I wet my palate with that scotch, my tongue all of a sudden didn't experience a lot of the flavor, but the smoke in my mouth was able to expand and give me a lot more of the sensory of this cigar. I tasted more, I felt it more everywhere. Blowing it out, I got a better experience. Pairings can really change your cigar experience. And you don't have to pair it with alcohol. I mean, I know guys that pair their cigars with tequila, champagne, scotch mostly, scotches and whiskeys. But I also know people that like to pair it with coffee, that's a great one, as well as orange juice and chocolate milk. Chocolate milk's a very interesting one. I recommend you try that. But I'd also recommend doing it with a scotch or a whiskey with this one. I know, scotches are whiskeys. With that being said, I'm gonna go away again, and when I come back, we're gonna take off this final band, see how that performs, and then we're gonna go into the Rod score, or the Republic of Debauchery score. Welcome back. We're now getting pretty close to that final third of the cigar. This is a pretty long stick, and it's time to remove the final band and see what happens. Let's ashes first, and again, fantastic quality ash. This might even be able to stand up on its own ash. I think it's really cool when people do that. Boom, there it is. It doesn't get better than that. A foot and two bands on every single cigar, never disappointed. That is very good quality control. Now let's get into the rod score. The wrapper. It doesn't have a smooth, shiny wrapper, but it also doesn't have any defects or thick veins in it. It's a gorgeous wrapper, and we gave it a 7 out of 10. The draw. This cigar drawed effortlessly throughout the entirety of the cigar, and we rated it a 7 out of 10. The burn line. Out of all the cigars we smoked, the burn line stayed consistent and pretty even all the way through, and we rated it a very high 8 out of 10. Flavor. This cigar has a lot of flavor, you can taste a lot of nuances in it, whether or not you have a chef's palate, and we gave it a 7 out of 10. Quality of smoke. It's a little bit dry, but it has a great mouthfeel, and we gave it a 6 out of 10. Second half of the cigar. It stayed pretty consistent throughout the whole smoke, and we gave it a 7 out of 10. The band. They obviously put a lot of attention to detail in the band, and it came off seamlessly every time. We gave it an 8 out of 10. Consistency. We've smoked a lot of these cigars over quite a long time, and the cigar always tasted the same and smoked the same and burned the same, and we gave it an 8 out of 10. Availability. We found this cigar on 3 out of 4 online retailers, as well as 3 out of 4 local shops, and we gave it a 7 out of 10. The value, and this is one of the most important points on our scoring system. We give this cigar a 6 out of 10 because for the price point, you won't be disappointed. That brings this cigar to a 71 total score. The Rocky Patel 60 is an above average cigar, but it has an above average price. However, we don't think you'll be disappointed dropping $16 on this cigar. So go out, maybe not buy a box, but definitely treat yourself to it once in a while. So there you have it, a 71 out of 100. We think that's going to be a pretty high sitting score going forward, but only the future will tell. Now, if you enjoyed this review, please hit that subscribe button. We're going to try and do something different, keep it interesting, and give an overall score that'll help newer smokers and casual smokers a lot more than those expert scores out there. Also, we're going to be putting out a video very soon describing in depth on how we score cigars and why we chose that system. Thank you for watching, and enjoy your smoke.